فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The scholars, they have three names that they call it, this one. Some scholars, they call it Kufru Inkar. Some call it Kufru Al-Takdhib. Some, they call it Kufru Al-Jahli. Are you there? They all mean the same. They're only looking at it where it occurs from. Like, for example, the ones who call it Kufru Al-Jahli, they're saying the cause for it is ignorance. The ones who call it Kufru Al-Inkar, they're saying that the rejection is coming from the heart. The ones who call it Kufru Al-Takdhib, meaning that it's, the kufr is coming from the tongue, the person's actually saying it. Are you there? Does that make sense? This person doesn't, so what does it mean? This person has rejected, kufr al-inkar means to reject Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this person doesn't know Allah, doesn't know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, doesn't know anything. Are you there? This is kufr. The second one is called what? Yeah? What's the second one called? Kufr al-juhud. What does kufr al-juhud mean? The person knows Allah in their heart, but they don't want to accept it on their tongue. Are you with me, brothers? Kufr al-inkar? At all. La qalban wa la qaliban. No, internally or externally, he doesn't accept it. This one, on the other hand, he does. Baghawi mentions the ta'rif for it. أَنْ يَعْرِفَ اللَّهَ بِقَلْبِهِ. He knows Allah in his heart. وَلَا يَعْتَرِفَ بِلِسَانِهِ. But he doesn't recognize him with his tongue. So in his heart, he believes in Allah. But in his tongue, he's disbelieving. It's kufr. Kufr. Are you there, brothers? This is the one that Fir'aun came with. Allah says in the Quran, وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلْوًا. Fir'aun, did he know that he was not ilah? Did he know that? Yeah, he knew that. He knew that he wasn't God. He did. But what was he saying on his tongue? I don't know. What was he saying? أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرَ وَهَذِهِ الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي. Am I not the owner of Misr, Egypt? It's all of mine. And all of the rivers that flow, is they all for me? أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَىٰ. I am your supreme Lord. لَيْسَ لِي, what do you don't have a God besides me. What did it say? Abdul Razak. He says, إِلَهَ مِنْ دُونِي. مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرِي. I don't know for you a ilah other than me. All of this was juhud. Juhud here means Fir'aun, he knew it in his heart that wasn't the case. How do we know that he knew in his heart? How would we know that? The way we know that, because Allah referred to it as juhud. Look what he said, وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ. He was, his heart affirmed this. Allah said, وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ. His nafs affirmed that. But he was saying in his tongue, kufr. Are you there, brothers and sisters? Yeah? Also another one, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about Fir'aun? What did he say? لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ مَا أَنزَلَ هَؤُلَىٰ إِلَىٰ رَبِّ السَّمَوَاتِ. When Musa said to him, you know, Fir'aun, that no one sent this down on me except Allah. You know this is from the religion of Allah. You know that. All of this is clear for you. You're fully aware of it. Are you with me? So Fir'aun was juhud. And many people will say that their parents are like that. That when they explain to their parents Islam, their parents will look at them and say to them, you know, well, what you're saying is making sense. Or they would argue just for the sake of argument. All day they will just keep arguing. Yeah? A lot of reavers will tell you this. But they know that their parents believe this. This makes sense. You're just being stubborn. You're just being hard-headed. You know this is the truth. I know you know this is the truth. This is kufr al-ju'ud. Are you with me, brothers? ولذلك الله said, what he said about the Quran, فلما جاءهم ما عرفوا كفروا به فلعنة الله على الكافرين. فلما جاءهم, when it came to them, ما عرفوا, that which they knew, the kufar, Allah said, when it came to them, that which they recognized, كفروا به, they disbelieved in it. This is called kufr al-juhud. All that came to them was the signs that were mentioned about the Prophet ﷺ in their books. They knew these signs were in him. They found it in him. They recognized that this was the reality. But juhud was what they were sticking to. This is the kufr of the Yahud and Fir'aun and his people. The scholars, they categorize the juhud into two types. The first one is that the person's juhud is unrestrictedly. It's juhud which is mutlaq, unrestricted juhud. He does juhud of Allah's rububiyyah. Like atheists today. Yeah? Atheists, Richard Dawkins, Sam Harris, Christopher Hitchens, and all of these guys, they have juhud in them. It's impossible they don't believe God's existence. Impossible. Musta'eel. They're just juhud. These type of people are the worst. Huh? Well, the atheists always talk about a concept called, they have something called they have something called bed confession. When they're on their last moments of life, they really confess and they say, oh, they regret what they were upon. Zah? Because the stubbornness in their hearts, the stubbornness in their tongue, which their heart was affirming, when now they're about to die, they start speaking the truth. They start saying things, huh? And a lot of them even come back from it, right? They come back, they repent, they affirm it. I was reading a book written by, what's this one? There is no God. It's called There Is a God Now. It crosses it out. Anthony Flew. Anthony Flew has a book called There Is No God. But it crosses out the word no. And it says a God. He used to be an atheist before. Kani Yuladru. He used to argue for the atheist and push the concept of the atheist. One of the chapters that he talks about is the concept of juhud. Kufr al-juhud. That this is stubbornness and hard-headedness from them. That they know God exists and they believe that. The second type of kufr al-juhud is muqayyad, is restricted. It means that the person's only jahid on a fard min furud al-Islam. Sister will say, I don't believe in hijab, man. This is kufr akbar. She leaves the religion. But this kufr is not mutlaq. Sorry, this juhud is not mutlaq. She's not saying the whole religion. Her juhud here is what? A obligatory thing from the furud of Islam. Or something that's haram, they're becoming jahid on it. Okay? Or a news from the news of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. A hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a juhud is coming from a particular thing. So it's not everything. The scholars, they mentioned that. You can go to Ibn al-Qayyim's Kitab Madarij al-Salikin, the first volume, page 337, he expands on it. The third type of kufr we mentioned was what? Kufr? Huh? Kufr al-inad. What does inad mean? Inad means the person doesn't reject the truth, nor do they accept it. They don't reject it, nor do they accept it. This is the one that the people of Abdi Yalil, when the Prophet ﷺ came to him in Ta'if, remember? When the Prophet ﷺ asked for help, and they said to him, go and meet these people. Who did the Prophet ﷺ go and meet? He met Abdi Yalil and his brother. So what did they do with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? When he told them the truth, and he finished what he wanted to say, they said, if you are telling the truth, they said, if you are lying, then you're not worth our time. And if you are telling the truth, then you're greater than us. And they left it there. They didn't reject, nor did they accept. You hear that a lot from a lot of Christians. They'll say to you, I ain't got nothing against Christianity. I ain't got nothing against you Muslims. You know? I ain't no problem. I don't like you guys. I don't hate you guys. Do what you have to do. Huh? I'm not for Islam. I'm not against Islam. Huh? I'm not rejecting the concept of monotheism that you guys call to, nor am I affirming it. This is called kufr inad. It's called kufr. It's called kufr al-inad. This is something that was found in Abu Talib. Abu Talib recognized everything, was saying it on his tongue, but he wasn't saying the shahada. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُ بِأَنَّ دِينَ مُحَمَّدٍ He said, مِنْ خَيْرِ أَدْيَانِ الْبَرِيَّةِ دِينًا لَوْلَا الْمَلَامَةُ أَوْ حِذَارًا مُسَبَّتٍ لَوَجَدْتَنِي سَمْحًا بِذَاكَ مُبِينًا Abu Talib was not for or against. صحيح? He wasn't for the Prophet in the sense where he went into, came into Islam and came into full Islam. Nor is he against the Prophet ﷺ. He wasn't showing any enmity or hatred towards the Prophet ﷺ on his da'wah. He was letting him spread it. صح? This is called kufr al-inad. This is, scholars differ within themselves the definition of it. The fourth type of kufr we said is called kufr. Kufr al-nifaq. Kufr al-nifaq means the opposite of what? Kufr al-juhud. It's the opposite of what? Kufr al-juhud. Sahih? It means that the person doesn't believe it in their heart. Kufr al-juhud, what did they believe in their heart, right? But they were disbelieving in their tongue. Nifaq here is the opposite of juhud. It means أن يقر باللسان. The person affirms it on his tongue. ولا يعتقد بالقلب. But he doesn't believe in his heart. That's the definition Baghawi gave. Ibn al-Qayyim gave the same as well. That the person on his tongue, he's with the Muslims. He's supporting them. He argues for the Muslims. He's part of, but in his heart, he doesn't believe any of that. And the hypocrisy is two types. Kufr, that which is akbar, major. And there's another one called minor. Major or minor. The major is called nifaq i'tiqadi. And the minor is called what? Nifaq what? A'mali. Like the thalatha, the three people, the Prophet ﷺ said, علامة المنافق ثلاثة. The sign of a hypocrite is three. إذا حدث كذب when he talks he lies. وإذا وعد أخلف when he makes a promise he breaks the promise. وإذا تؤمن خان if you trust him with something he breaks them. He's a hypocrite. But the hypocrisy here is what? Minor. It's not major. The fifth type of kufr is called kufr al-i'rad. Major and minor. اعتقادي and عملي. اعتقادي is the one Allah said, إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار. That the person is in the hellfire. The munafiqin who are in the worst, the lowest level in the hellfire. Like the nifaq of Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. This is nifaq which is what? اعتقادي. Sorry brothers, I confused two. The definition I gave for kufr al-inad was meant to be for kufr al-i'rad. Are you with me, brothers? The definition I gave for kufr al-inad was actually meant to be for kufr al-i'rad, which is the sixth one, the fifth one I'm going to mention now. Are you there, brothers? The definition I gave for kufr al-inad is actually kufr al-i'rad. Are you there, brothers? It's the fifth one I'm mentioning now. Let me mention kufr al-inad then. Kufr al-inad is kufr al-inad is that the person admits the or he recognizes the truth but he refuses to accept it, like the kufr of Abu Talib. Like the kufr of what? Abu Talib. Abu Talib's kufr is kufr al-inad. Sah. He knew, he recognized the truth in his heart. He even recognized it on his tongue, but he doesn't make it his religion. He believes in his heart. He believes it on his tongue. And he admits this is the truth. How you say take the shahada? No. Maybe because of our forefathers. Maybe because of money. Maybe because of leadership. Hiraqla was the same, Azim al-Rum, who admitted that the Prophet ﷺ is the true religion of the Prophet ﷺ, his deen is the religion of truth. This is called kufr al-inad. Are you with me? Kufr al-i'rad. Kufr al-i'rad means the person turns away his hearing, his heart, meaning he doesn't accept, nor does he reject. لا يصدقه ولا يكذبه. He won't say I believe in it, and he won't say I reject it. And I mentioned this is the example of Abdi Yalil, where they said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they said, "Wallahi la aqulu laka kalimat." And he said, "I'm not going to say a word to you, Muhammad. إن كنت صادقا, if what you're saying is the truth, فأنت أجل في عيني من أن أرد عليك. If you're telling the truth, then you are greater for me to respond to you. وإن كنت كاذبا, and if you're lying, فأنت أحقر من أن أكلمك. And if you're lying, then you are low for me to even talk to you." And he left it out there. So there's إعراض. They turn away. Allah said in the Quran, والذين كفروا عما أُذِرُوا معرضين. المعرضون والذين كفروا, those who are disbelievers, عما أنذروا, that which they have been warned from, they are معرضون, they turn away from it. And this is the ayah that Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah, he used for kufr al-i'rad. The last one, which is called kufr al-shaki. Kufr al-shaki is the kufr of doubt. Is when the person starts doubting the religion. And the religion, they doubt it. So they say, I don't know if the Prophet is telling the truth. I don't know if he's lying or not, I don't know if he's telling the truth. And this is the example of that Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab used, rahimahullah ta'ala, he used the kufr al-shak. He used قوله تعالى وَدَخَلَ الْمَدِينَةِ وَدَخَلَ الْجَنَّةَ هُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ مَا أَظُنُّ I don't think so أن تبيد هذه الأبدا وما أظنُّ I don't believe أن الساعة قائمة that the hour is going to come I don't believe وما أظنُّ I don't think so شك is doubt he's not saying clearly but he's saying I don't think so قائمة وَلَئِن رُدِدْتُ إِلَى رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِنْهَا مُنْقَلَبًا So it's called كفر الشكي and it's also called كفر الظن, the kufr of shak or kufr of dhan. So those are the six types of kufr when it comes to what's the root cause for it. Okay? Now we're going to go to this, the next type of categorization. Okay? Which is, where does kufr occur from? Where does it occur from? Where can a person do kufr from? Their body parts. Kufr can be done from the heart, number one. Number two, kufr can occur from the speech of a person. And last but not least, a kufr can occur from a person's actions. And the scholars all say that when they talk about apostasy, they all mention it. Like for example, if you look at the statement of Muhammad ibn Abdul Rahman al-Uthmani, he mentions, he says, الردّة to apostasy is قطع الإسلام بقول أو فعل أو نية is to disconnect Islam either by speech, action or intention. Meaning, مرعي بن يوسف الكرمي he said ويحصل الكفر كفر كان أكاد بأربعة أمور four things القول والفعل والاعتقاد والشك and شك can fall under اعتقاد his name is called مرعي بن يوسف الكرمي مرعي بن يوسف الكرمي He says that kufr occurs from four. Al-qawlu, speech. Wabil-fi'li, action. Wabil-i'tiqadi, and belief. Wabil-shakki, and doubt. And doubt can be brought under i'tiqad, so it's actually three. Uthman ibn Muhammad al-Bakriyu al-Shafi'iyu. Uthman ibn Muhammad al-Bakriyu al-Shafi'iyu. He mentions in Dalil al-Talib, وَحَاصِلُ الْكَلَامِ The summarization and the conclusion is, على أنواع الردة when it comes to the types of apostasy is أنها تنحصر في ثلاثة أقسام that it is restricted to three types اعتقادات which is what? Beliefs وأفعال and actions وأقوال and speeches. وَكُلُّ قِسْمٍ مِنْهَا يَتَشَعَّبُ شُعَبًا كَثِيرًا. And each one, so many branches come down from it. So from the kalam of the aqwal of the ulama, the statements of the scholars we take from them is what? The kufr in terms of where it occurs from the body is how many types? Huh? Three. Good. Don't worry about the statement of Mar'a ibn Yusuf al-Karmi. I said to you, shak falls under what? Al-i'tiqad. So it's not four types, actually three types. Let's touch on each one. The first one is al-kufr al-qalbiyu. The kufr that occurs from the heart. The kufr that occurs from the heart is when a person believes that the Prophet lied, for instance. I'tiqadu, to believe, kadhib al-rasuli, that the Prophet lied, for instance. Or to disbelieve in your heart something that the Prophet ﷺ came with. Or to even doubt the Prophet ﷺ is on his integrity and his truthfulness. Or even to believe in your heart Allah, somebody creates with Allah, or somebody associates partners with Allah in his rububiyah or his uluhiyah, or even his asma'i wa sifat, in his names and attributes. Or believing in your heart something is halal and permissible for you when it's haram. All of these are mukaffirat i'tiqadiyya. These all are major kufr that occur from where? The heart.
So when you know it's haram.
Yeah, the person, something that's haram, that he knows is haram. No one will mention the shurut, that'll take people out of it later. But the point here, we need to just know, is kufr akbar, this action itself. This belief is kufr. Okay? And the person becomes a kafir from it. This is called kufr al-i'tiqadi. Sah? The second type is called kufr al-qawli. Kufr al-qawli, which is the kufr that occurs from what? Speech. Speech. For example, a person insults Allah or the Prophet, or he even claims prophecy. He says, Ana Rasulullah, I'm a prophet of Allah. Are you with me? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said in his Kitab al-Salim al-Maslul ala Shatim al-Rasul, he says, Man qala bi lisani kalimat al-kufri min ghayri jahajatin. Anybody who says a statement of kufr without any, there's no duress, he's not under any subjugation, no one's forcing him to do it. عَامِدًا لَهَا, he intends to do that. عَالِمًا بِأَنَّهَا كَلِمَةُ كُفْرٍ, and he knows it's a kufr statement. فَإِنَّهُ يَكْفُرُ بِذَلِكَ ظَاهِرًا وَبَاطِنًا. This person becomes a kafir externally and internally. Are we all together on that? This is now called what? Kufr? It's called what? Kufr qawli. Kufr qawli, the kufr qawli is two types. One that's akbar, and that one is that which is asghar. There's a kufr qawli which is akbar, the person leaves the religion. And there's a kufr qawli which is the person becomes kufr asghar. It's kufr but it's asghar. Are we all together? As for the kufr al-i'tiqadi is what? Paul akbar. The first one. Kufr al-i'tiqadi is always akbar. Kufr al-qawli, it has akbar and it has asghar. We now go to the third type of kufr, which is kufr al-amali. It's called what? Kufr al-amali. Kufr al-amali is the kufr that comes from the person's limbs. Okay? And this is also categorized into two. Kufr amali, which the person will leave, mukhrijun min al-millah, the person will leave the fold of Islam in totality, they become a kafir. And there's another one which is waghayru mukhrijin min al-millah, the person will not leave the fold of Islam. Ibn al-Qayyim says that, wa amma kufr al-amali fayanqasimu ila ma yudadu al-imana wa ila ma la yudaduhu. Ibn al-Qayyim says this. He says that the kufr which is action based, amali, is action, is categorized ila ma yudadu al-iman, that which opposes iman. It what? It opposes iman. Wa ila ma la yudaduhu, and that which does not oppose iman. Fasujudu lis-salami, prostrating to an idol. والاستهزاء بالمصحف والاستهانة بالمصحف and also belittling the مصحف وقتل النبي and killing a prophet وسبه insulting a prophet يضاد الإيمان and this goes against your إيمان meaning you disbeliever. This is مخرج من الملة. It'll take you out of the fold of Islam. Now he's going to mention that which is minor. He says, وَأَمَّا الْحُكْمُ بِغَيْرِ مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ He says, Ibn Taqayyim says this. He says, as for ruling by other than what Allah has set down, وَتَرْكُ الصَّلَاةِ and leaving the prayer, فَهُوَ مِنَ الْكُفْرِ الْعَمَلِيِّ قَطْعًا It's that which doesn't take you out of the fold of Islam. Ruling by other than what Allah has set down, and leaving the prayer, Ibn Taqayyim sees it to be what? Minor kufr. ولا يمكن أن ينفى عنه اسم الكفر بعد أن أطلقه الله ورسوله عليه. We're not allowed to take the term كفر away from him. The one who leaves the salah of salah, we're going to call him a kafir. But كفر أصغر. The term we can't take it away from it because the Sharia already used that term for it. حكم بغير ما أنزل الله, we use كفر for that. The one who leaves the action of leaving prayer, we call that كفر. We won't take that term kufr away from it. But the kufr here is minor, he says. فَالْحَاكِمُ بِغَيْرِ مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ كَافِرٌ The one who rules by other than what Allah has sent down is a kafir. وَتَارِكُ الصَّلَاةِ The one who leaves the prayer, kafirun is a kafir. بِنَصِّ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ Because of the Prophet's statement. وَلَكِنْ بَطْ هُوَ كُفْرٌ عَمَلٍ لَا كُفْرُ اعْتِقَادٍ It's kufr amali and it's not kufr اعْتِقَادٍ Kufr amali here means what? Minor. Fine. That's what he means by it. You see, this is whose statement? Ibn al-Qayyim. Now let's move on to the second, the third, how many, which type are we on categorization of? How much have we categorized it so far? The first one was bi'itibari hukmihi. The second one was what? Bi'itibari bawa'ithi wa asbabihi. The third one was what? Bi'itibari? Huh? بإعتباري و we on the second one we did the second we did two so the third one was بإعتباري ما يقوم به من أعضاء البدن right we're now going to move on to the fourth صح we're now going to do the fourth one am I right which is أقسام الكفر بإعتباري كوني أصليا أو طارئا كفر in terms of it being always there Or is it something that came later? Okay. Now this is an issue which we need to talk about. Is that this type of kufr is two types. Kufr asli. A person who was always a kafir. He never ever entered into Islam. He never believed in the Prophet's prophecy. Like the kufr of the mushrikeen and the Ahlul Kitab, the Jews, the Christians. Like the kufr of the Majus, the fire worshippers. Those who worship idols. Okay, the Dahriyin, the naturalists, the philosophers, the Sabians. These are all kuffar, but they're kuffar asliyin. They were always kuffar. The scholars, they categorize the kuffar asliyin into three. The asli kuffar, who were always kuffar, are categorized into three. The first of them is Ahlul Kitab, the people of the book. The people of the book are two types, Christians and Jews. Christians and the Jews. The book that they have was the Torah and Injil. And Allah refers to them as what? وَطَعَامُ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ حِلُّ لَكُمْ وَطَعَامُكُمْ حِلُّ لَهُمْ The Ahlul Kitab, the Kuffar which are asli Ahlul Kitab, what do we say about them? Their food is permissible for us, their slaughter. Okay, the Christians and the Jews. What they slaughter is permissible shara'an. Two, their women who are Christians and Jews are a Muslim man is allowed to marry. But the Quran conditioned one thing, that woman has to be what? She has to be chaste. Like the nuns, for instance, a nun, na'am. Because nuns are chaste, generally. They don't, they should be. Some of them are not. Some of them are chilling with the priest. Yeah, but generally they shouldn't have any relationship with any man. They're meant to be pious. They're meant to behave themselves. So since she's chaste, the Muslim can marry her. And she's Ahlul Kitab now. Many Muslims today are not really aware that we're living in a country where they're secularists. They're not Christian, they've left Christianity. They've done ridda and apostasy of Christianity. And Judaism, they're not Christians and Jews. They left it, they walked away from that. A lot of them are atheists. So when a person goes to McDonald's and says, وَطَعَمُ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ حِلُّ لَكُمْ, I'm just saying, is McDonald's Christians? If you ask those who are working, they'll say to you, no. صح? The organization of McDonald's, they will even tell you that they're not Christians. They don't follow religion. صح? Even this country, they'll tell you, big head, the people running the country, they don't observe Christianity. So I'm just saying, if we can agree that they're not Christians, then وَطَعَمُ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ حِلُّ لَكُمْ is off track, right? It's off topic. Countries like America, there's a lot of Christians in America. You know, there are more Christians than you find in the UK. These individuals here, Christianity has died out. I mean, have you guys never come across Jehovah's Witness? Jehovah's Witness, they do takfir of the other Christians. Huh? But even if you talk to normal Christians, they'll tell you, majority of the people are not Christians. Not that I'm telling you go around and talk to Christians. But I'm just saying, even the normal Christians will tell you that this country is a changed country. I remember one time I invited one Jehovah's Witness into my house. So he came into my library, sat down, looked at the books and said, wow. I said, wow, you read this stuff? I said, yeah, I read. He goes to me, because now he's heartbroken. He wanted to give da'wah to me. And he's trying to give da'wah to me and I'm trying to give da'wah to him. So we spoke for a while, I bought him biscuits, cakes, and I said to him, okay, what is it that you've come for? So he told me about Christianity, and I asked him simple questions, discussion. And if you look at the Jehovah's Witness, they're tablighis, that's what they are. The tablighi, you know the tablighi group that we have? It's the Christian version of the tablighis. Huh? So we were having a conversation and stuff. So he was denying all other Christianities, all of them. They're not Muslims. They're not Christians, real Christians. We are the real Christians. Huh? So the concept of Christianity, Ahlul Kitab, even though it changes over time, but do they still claim they're Christians? That's the core point. We're not going to say that the Christians have changed within themselves, so we can't eat their food. No, we can, even if they change. But the thing is, are these people Christians? A guy marries his girlfriend and he says, the women from the people of the scripture is permissible for you? Marrying their women? Actually, she's saying to you loudly, I ain't no Christian. Samantha is saying, I'm not a Christian. Clearly, she said, I am not a Christian. I've apostated from Christianity. I've left that. I don't believe in God. And you're like, that their women are permissible for you. That doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense. So the first one are, the scholars differ, who are Ahlul Kitab. Some other scholars, they try to put more than two, but the strongest is that it's only these two. The second one is, those who are different on whether they, so second time, is مُخْتَلَفٌ فِيهِمْ, there's a dispute, whether they are Ahlul Kitab or not. Example, the Majus, the fire worshippers, that's one. Also the ones that are the Sabi'un, the Sabians. The Nasara of Bani Taghlab, the scholars, they differed whether they should be added to Christianity or not, Ahlul Kitab. And there's groups like that today we can say, like for example, what's those groups that live in America? The Mormons, you see, are they Ahlul Kitab? Can we add them to it? They're مُخْتَلَفٌ فِيهِ. Huh? They're مُخْتَلَفٌ فِيهِ. You can't unjustly add the Mormons to Christianity. The reason why you can't is because you would have to add Qadianis to Islam then. Huh? Because they have left fundamental tendencies of their religion that they believe. Huh? Ala kulli hal, what do you call it? There is مُخْتَلَفِ. The third type of Christian kufar are Kufar Asli are مَلَّا كِتَابَ لَهُ. They have no books. They're not people of the book. They are abadatul awthan, idol worshippers. They are the naturalists. And they are also the falasifa, the philosophers. Number two is kufrun bari. They're not original disbelievers. Their kufr here is ridda, they apostated. So it's a Muslim, he left Islam. He apostated. This is called murtad. And a murtad is arraju an deen al-Islam ila al-kufri. Murtad actually means a person who just leaves Islam. That's the definition that Al-Imam Ibn Qudama mentions in his Kitab al-Mughni. Abdurrahman Nasir al-Sa'di mentions in his Irshad ila Ma'rifat al-Ahkam. This concept that apostasy means that the person has to do treason to the government and whatnot. Hada ma anzal Allah biha min sultan. There's no, that's nothing, it doesn't exist. Apostasy means, ridda means, you leave Islam. You are no longer a Muslim. That's it. He doesn't have to do anything to anybody. The fact that he leaves Islam, he's a murtad. Allah says to us in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَرْتَدِدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ فَيَمُتْ وَهُوَ كَافِرٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. Those ones who've apostated from the religion and they die in that state, they are kuffar. And their righteous deeds will all be nullified in this dunya and in the hereafter. And they are the people of the hellfire. And they're going to stay in the hellfire forever. The last type of kufr is it kufr in terms of bi'itibari itlaqi wa ta'yini. It be used unrestrictedly or restrictedly. Kufr, when it's used in this type of categorization, is restricted and unrestricted. It's two types. For example, the Quran uses kufr and it's using it unrestrictedly. To take that kufr and to place it on somebody is now called ta'yin. So the first one is called itlaq, it's a takfir al-mutlaq. And then taking that takfir, which is general, like for example, we now know anyone who leaves the prayer is a kafir, for instance. Okay? For you now to go and to say, Zayd, you are a kafir, is now placing that unrestricted kufr on that person. Are we together? So the first one is called ta'liquhu ala wasf al-a'am min qawlin aw fi'lin aw i'tiqad. The kufr here is not connected to a particular person. It's connected to a description. That's what mutlaq means. Is when the kufr is connected to a description. For example, the Sharia says anyone who says this kafara is a kufr. As Allah said in the Quran, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةٌ كَفَرَ. The second type is called takfir, which is what? A takfir which is مُعَيَّن. The Sharia comes and it specifies a particular individual. As Allah said in the Quran, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا امْرَأَةَ نُوحٍ وَامْرَأَةَ لُوطٍ. Nuh and Lut's wives, kuffar. Allah specifically referred to them as kuffar. He by name mentioned them. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah mentioned a very powerful point here. This is one of the biggest problems that you find with many people, which is, when the kufr comes unrestricted in the kitab and the sunnah, to place it on a person, it needs extra evidences. It's not enough the fact that the Quran or the sunnah refer to this as kufr. Are we all together? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, "Inna takfir al-mutlaqa," the unrestricted takfir that we find in the Quran and the sunnah, "la yastalzimu takfir al-shakhsi," does not necessitate to make takfir of a particular person. Al-mu'ayyan, hatta taqum al-hujjata, التي يكفر تاركها, unless the proof has been established on this particular individual. Are we all together? This is very important. The Quran and the Sunnah, it makes takfir of something. You can't come and do what? Take that ruling that the Quran and Sunnah mentioned and specify on a particular person, unless you have established the proof, as Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentioned. And we're going to be speaking about this one in depth and in details, inshallah ta'ala, later bi-idhnillah al-kareem. I will conclude there for today, inshallah ta'ala. Tomorrow bi-idhnillah al-kareem. And when I say tomorrow, I mean next Monday, we will go through the shu'ab of al-kufr, the branches of kufr, in more details and the evidence pertaining to that. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.